He's phenomenal, isn't he? He started me in the business, you know.
Did he really?
Without, he doesn't realise he did, but he did. I was when I was still school teaching in the 60s, I was going around the clubs earning a few quid, and Doddy was my idol then. That's in the 60s. He was king then. And I went, the first time I went to see him, I saw him at the Opera House in Blackpool, and I watched two shows, 3,500 people in each house.
Wow.
Right, so that's 7,000 people. He did a total of 6 hours.
Extraordinary.
2 3-hour sets. And he's still doing marathons now. And what a technician, what a craftsman.
Yeah.
He is an awesome talent, and still loves it, still gets excited about it.
Oh, absolutely. And you forget as well that, you know, as well as being an amazing comedian, he's one of the best-selling musical artists in British history. I mean, I think Tears for Souvenirs has sold more records still than John Lennon's Imagine. It's a remarkable success.
Did he really?
Yeah, incredible.
I know in the 60s he was... I went 13 times in the year of 69, maybe 70, 69, I think. Maybe even before that. I went 13 times one season to watch him, and I every night sat and was completely mesmerised by the fact that this man with a funny hat and a tickling stick and a big bass drum can mesmerise 3,500 people and evoke such enjoyment from one body, you know.
Yeah.
And I thought, what must that feel like? And obviously it must feel all right because he's still doing it.
Exactly. Yeah, one of the greatest days of my life. He invited me to Buckingham Palace with him in February for the knighthood, and it was just so wonderful to see him finally become Sir Ken Dodd. About time too.
Really?
Yeah.
That must have been marvellous for you.
Yeah, it was a great honour. Great honour.
Oh, yeah. There'll never be another.
No.
He's a complete one-off. I mean, we had the Max Millers, and we had all that era of the 30s, Arthur Askey. But put in context against Ken, pales into insignificance, really.
I don't know about you, but I don't think there can be any other artist in British history has sold more live tickets than him, just because he's been doing it so long and consistently.
The pure longevity of the performance is 50 years.
Incredible.
And he's worked 3 and 4 times a night, 7 nights a week.
That's right.
For decades.
Yeah, I think 1964 he did the Palladium 2 shows a day, Monday to Friday, 3 on a Saturday, and then went to Liverpool on the Sunday and came back and did it for 9 months. Incredible.
Get off.
Yeah, true. True story.